Hello, this is Megha Pandre, and today we will be doing the new part of this chapter, lesson number 14, India, Location, Geological Structure and Physiography. And today we will cover rocks, which are the different varieties of rocks which are available in India. So let's continue. Here we will continue with the diversity in the physical features of India. Every region has its own distinct characteristics, and yet all regions are interconnected with each other. All of them have important contribution in the progress of the nation and are useful in the forest resources. For example, northern fertile plain are also called as the storehouse of grains, and southern plateau. The southern peninsula is rich in many mineral resources, which has enhanced the national progress. Many rivers with large volume of water originates in the northern mountainous region, which is also known for a variety of forest resources. So these are the reasons which shows that diversity, although there is diversity in the physical features, but then also they are interrelated with one another. Here we will continue with the rocks. A composite matter. Composite matter means made up of several parts. Made up of one or more mineral is called a rock. Rock can be hard as well as soft. They can be porous or non-porous, light or heavy in weight. So various types of rocks are formed due to different process. Rocks can be divided into three types. First, igneous rock, stratified rocks, and metamorphic rock. So we will continue with the igneous rock. Now, the intense heat in the interior of the earth is responsible for the formation of these rock. The interior of the earth remains very hot due to this heat. So the matter here is in semi-liquid state, which is called magma. Eventually, when this magma cools down, rocks are form. So basically, this is how the formation of rocks takes place. These rocks are formed due to the effect of heat. Hence, these are called igneous rock or agneya rock. In the formation of the crust of the earth, these rocks were formed earliest. So these are also called as the primary rock. At many places in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, and southern peninsula in India, such rocks have formed. Igneous rocks are most solid of all rocks. Granite is one of the example of plutonic rock. Basalt is also this type of a rock. Now, the second one is called stratified rock. Igneous rock disintegrate due to the collective effect of disintegrates means breaks. Why does it breaks? Due to the collective effect of water and other forces. These are also known as sedimentary rocks. The broken rock material is constantly deposited in water and they form layers. So here you can see the layers are being formed of different colors and they have made as somewhat like pattern. And thus rock material is deposited into different layers. So these are the different layers which are being formed. The upper layer exerts pressure over the layers of the underlying rock, which were formed initially and are lying at the bottom, and eventually rock are formed with different layers. They are called as stratified rocks. Its example are gypsum, limestone, and coal. Coal and gypsum are obtained from Bihar and Jharkhand states. And the last rock we will be doing is called metamorphic rock. In certain peculiar condition, the form, composition, and other characteristics of rocks are totally changed due to the combined effect of the two factors. Which are those factors? High temperature and pressure of rock strata. And sedimentary rock change into a totally new form. These newly formed rock are called metamorphic rock. Marble, quartzite available in Rajasthan are these examples. So here I end up with this part. We will meet in the next part. Until then, goodbye.